world records under threat, more Olympic relay spots decided, and the first meetings of this year's Diamond League. My name is Alex, and this is your athletics update for May 2021. May was a strong month for Venezuelan triple jumper Yulimar Rojas, who opened her competitive season with a jump of 15m 14 in Ibiza on the 8th of the month, before extending her personal best by 2cm to 15m 43 in Andujar on the 22nd. Rojas's mark from Andujar takes her only 7cm away from the world record in the event, which was set by Ukrainian athlete Inessa Kravets at the 1995 World Championships in Gothenburg. American shot putter Ryan Crouser found similar success this month, becoming only the third man ever to throw the shot put further than 23 metres, having launched the implement out to 23 metres and 1 centimetre at the USATF Throws Festival in Tucson, Arizona. This brings Crouser only 11 centimetres short of Randy Barnes's 31-year-old world record in the event, set in Westwood, California in May 1990. At the Hypo meeting in Gotzis, Austria, in what is widely considered to be the biggest competition of the year for multi-eventers outside of the major championships, Canadian decathlete Damien Warner set the fourth highest score in the history of the decathlon. Warner's 8,995 point series included two world decathlon bests, logging 8m 28 in the long jump and 13.36 seconds in the 110m hurdles. The 2016 Olympic bronze medalist also ran the 100m in Gotzis in 10.14 seconds, only 0.02 of a second slower than the world decathlon best time he set at the same meeting in 2019. Second place in the decathlon in the Austrian town was Warner's fellow Canadian Pierce Lepage, who improved on his personal best by 81 points, giving him a score of 8,534. Third place was taken by 2016 European champion Thomas van der Platzen with 8,430 points, 98 points more than his previous personal best from the 2016 Olympics. In the women's heptathlon in Gotzis, Zenia Krishtan set new personal bests across four events to win the competition with a Hungarian record of 6,651 points. Dutch heptathlete Anouk Vetter finished second, having scored 6,536 points, while Kendall Williams became the only one of five American entrants to complete the heptathlon in Gotzis, finishing third with 6,383 points. Jan Zielecny's long-standing world record in the javelin came under threat this May, with Johannes Vetter launching the spear out to a world lead of 94m and 20cm in Ostrava in the Czech Republic, only to improve on this mark at the European Team Championships in Chorzów, with a throw of 96m 29cm, the third furthest throw ever under current javelin specifications. Vetter's mark at the European Team Championships was 2m and 19cm short of Zielecny's record from 1996, and is 1m 47 off his own personal best set at the same stadium in 2020. Also at the European Team Championships in Silesia, Kristin Husong of Germany threw 69m 19 in the women's javelin for the 21st best recorded distance since the introduction of the current specification of javelin. Pavel Fajdek produced the 5th best throw of his career in the men's hammer to take the world lead of 82m 98, while Pia Sershashovska made European Team Championship history by becoming the first woman to win both the 100m and 100m hurdles at the same championships. In the team standings, host country Poland narrowly won the event with 181.5 points to second place Italy's 179. Great Britain came third on 174 points, with a failed changeover in the men's 4x400 relay costing them a higher placing. The Silesian Stadium in Chorzów also held the World Athletics Relays this month, where the Italian squad won the mixed 4x400 relay, having assured their Olympic qualification the previous day, with Ireland, the Dominican Republic, the Netherlands and Spain also qualifying a mixed team for Tokyo. Cuba won the women's 4x400 relay, thereby assuring their place at the Olympics alongside Germany, Italy and France. Denmark, Germany, Ghana and Italy each qualified a squad for the men's 4x100m relay in Tokyo, but it was the team from South Africa that won the final in Chorzów in 38.71 seconds. The women's 4x100 was won by Italy, with Denmark, Ecuador, France, Japan, the Netherlands and Poland all earning a women's sprint relay team for Tokyo. The Chula Vista Field Festival in California saw world leads in two events being set this month, with Vashti Cunningham clearing 2m and 2cm in the women's high jump, while Nigerian athlete Essa Brume leapt out to 7m 17 in the women's long jump, an effort which also broke Chioma Ajinwa's 25-year-old African record in the event. At the European Throwing Cup in Split, Croatia, Polish javelin thrower Maria Andrejczyk became the first woman to record a throw in excess of 70 metres since 2013. Andrejczyk's throw of 71 metres 40 in the Croatian city places her third on the all-time list for the women's javelin, with only Barbara Spartakova and Olis Delis Menendez having ever produced a better throw under the modern javelin specifications. The 70 metre mark was also exceeded in the women's discus this month by Dutch athlete Jorinde van Klinken in windy conditions in Tucson, Arizona, with her world-leading throw measuring in at 70 metres and 22 centimetres. This makes van Klinken the first woman born in the year 2000 or after to break the 70 metre barrier, a feat that only three other women have achieved in van Klinken's lifetime. The world lead in the men's long jump also fell this May, to Miltiadis Tentoglou with a jump of 8m60 in Athens, 16cm further than Javon Harrison's mark from April, and also 28cm further than Tentoglou's previous personal best from 2019. At the first Diamond League meeting of the season in Gateshead, Mohamed Khatir of Spain set a new 5,000m personal best of 13 minutes 8.52 seconds, almost 42 seconds ahead of his previous personal best from 2018, giving him the victory over Nicholas Kipkirui-Kameli and Michael Kibet of Kenya. Also in Gateshead, Dina Asher-Smith overcame the stormy conditions to beat a world-class field over the 100 metres in 11.35 seconds. Sha'Carri Richardson came second to Asher-Smith in Gateshead, marking the first time that the 21-year-old American athlete has been beaten in 2021. Marie-Josée Tarlu finished third in the race, while reigning world champion over the distance, Shelly-Ann Fraser-Pryce came fourth. The Doha leg of the Diamond League provided far more favourable conditions for the competitors, allowing Shelly-Ann Fraser-Pryce to register a season's best time of 10.84 over the 100 metres, with Blessing Okugbare finishing second in 10.90 seconds. The women's steeplechase was won by Nora Geruto of Kenya in a time of 9 minutes 0.67 seconds, while Makeda Sababa in second place set a new Ethiopian record in the event of 9 minutes 2.52 seconds. In the men's 400m hurdles, Rye Benjamin ran a meeting record of 47.38 seconds, having already set a world lead of 47.13 in Walnut, California in the same month. Alisson dos Santos of Brazil set a new South American record of 47.57 seconds in Doha, while Kyron McMaster of the British Virgin Islands finished third with a sub 48 second clocking, with his best performance of the month also coming in Walnut. Valerie Ullman of the United States recorded the furthest throw of the day in the women's discus, with her fourth round effort being measured at 65 metres 57 centimetres. However, Ullman only came second in the final standings in Doha, due to the final three format, which decides the victor based on the final round attempts across many field events. This format gave Jaime Perez of Cuba the victory, while Thomas Walsh of New Zealand won the men's shot put in a similar manner, having produced the furthest throw in the final round of 21m 63, placing him in first, even though Armin Sinancevic's Serbian record-breaking throw of 21m 88 was the furthest of the competition in Doha. Also in the Qatari capital, Katie Nagyot and Sandy Morris both set a new world lead of 4m 84 in the women's pole vault, while Yulimar Rojas jumped over 15 metres once again to take the victory in the women's triple jump, with Jamaican competitors Kimberly Williams and Shanika Ricketts both producing personal bests to finish second and third. Beatrice Cepkowicz's world record time in the women's 5km was bettered once again this month, this time by Karoline Grovdal of Norway, who ran the distance in 14 minutes 39 seconds in her home country. Grovdal's time is 4 seconds faster than Cepkowicz's time set in Monaco in February, and 2 seconds faster than the unratified time set by Beth Potter in April. Grovdal's time could, however, face the same fate as Potter's, due to the various requirements, including post-race anti-doping tests, required by the governing body to ratify world records. This May, British hammer thrower Sophie Hitchon announced her retirement from athletics. Throughout her career, Hitchon improved upon the British record in the hammer throw numerous times, with her best ever effort of 74m 54, taking her to the Olympic bronze medal in 2016, making her the first Briton to win an Olympic hammer throwing medal since 1924. More recently, Hitchon has struggled to throw in excess of 70 metres, and her decision to retire was influenced by this, saying that she has not been able to get to a position where she is challenging for medals, and that she only wants to compete if she can be at her best. And with that, you are up to date. June will see the European Para-Athletics Championships in Bydgoszcz, Poland, the continuation of the Diamond League in Florence, as well as national championships for numerous countries as they decide their teams ahead of the Olympic Games. Thank you for watching, don't forget to like and subscribe, and feel free to share your thoughts on recent track and field performance in the comments. I hope to see you soon for the next Athletics Update.